Hey, Vision Kids, it's me, Miss Penny, and today we are at a science museum to find out about coral reefs and other things that live under the sea. Are you ready for a sea adventure? Let's go.
Our first step, feeding fish in the mangrove area. Hooray!
My name is Bonnie. This is our mangroves exhibit here at Frost Science. I help take care of the fish here. I help take care of a lot of the different aquariums. We make sure that everything is running smoothly throughout the day. I also help out with all of the birds and the herps, the reptiles that are around.
Wow. Making
sure everything gets taken care of as it should.
And what's your job title?
My job in particular is aquarist. I specialize in jellies as well, but I help around and make sure that everything else gets done as it should.
Fantastic.
There he goes.
Oh, there's one.
Eat it.
It's not just fish that get fed in this area. Look at the birds. They also stick around for a meal. Let's check out the Coral Reef Aquarium. An aquarium is a big tank filled with water where we can see all kinds of fish and coral. What is coral? My friend Shannon, a conservationist here at the museum, knows all about coral.
Coral are actually a bunch of different things. They are an animal, so they're made up of a bunch of little polyps, which are all individual animals. Then they have a symbiotic relationship with plants, so algae, and that's what gives them their color. And so what symbiotic means is that they need two organisms are working together to be able to survive. So the polyps need the algae to get their nutrients, and the algae need a place to live. So they work together. And then they're also a rock. They build a calcium carbonate skeleton all on their own. So many people, when they see coral, they usually think, oh, it's a rock. But it's not just a rock. There's plants and animals too.
It's amazing.
It's amazing. It's like a little city in there. So each one of these individual bumps is its own polyp, and that's an individual animal.
What is this exhibit we have here?
So this is one of our Reef Florida exhibits, and we're kind of showcasing some of the coral restoration efforts that's happening on Florida's coral reef. And so what that means is scientists are finding ways to help protect our coral reef by planting, we say outplanting, corals back out onto the reef. So we glue them to the ocean floor, and then they can grow out in the wild.
So why are corals so important?
Corals are so important for so many different reasons. They help keep our oceans clean, they provide habitat or homes for our fish and food for our fish, and they help protect us against big storms.
Tell us about the word restoration. What does that mean?
Yes, so the word restoration means to restore something back to what it was before. And so our coral reefs used to be very, very healthy, and right now they're experiencing lots of different threats. And so scientists are going out to try to bring that back or restore it. And that's restoration.
To learn even more about coral, let's visit my friend Denise in the Discovery Lab.
We're all going to become scientists today. Coral scientists, coral researchers, okay?
Denise knows what coral needs to stay healthy.
They need some requirements in their habitat, in the ocean where they live, just like us. Imagine you would live somewhere that is too cold and you didn't have a jacket. Would you like that? Not. Or somewhere where it's really, really hot and you wouldn't have air conditioning. Would you like that?
No.
Corals don't like that either. So we're gonna learn about that in just a minute. This you can touch, see? And this is a coral. And these, you're touching their rock component. And in here, there used to be a little animal called a polyp. What is one thing that you can see in this video of a healthy coral reef?
Lots of fishes.
Very good, thank you, Eden.
Lots of corals.
What else can you see? There's a lot of fish, There's a lot of life going on around, loads of colors, maybe. Do you see more than one color?
No.
Yes. No? Yes,
that's lots. A whole rainbow.
A whole rainbow of colors. Very good, thank you. So when a coral reef is healthy, you have life going on and you have a lot of colors, right? Everything's going on because coral reefs are a really important ecosystem. Do you ever take a bath with really, really hot water? The water has to be just right. And the corals like their water just right too. When the corals live somewhere where the water is just right, at the right temperature for them to thrive, that means to be healthy and to be happy, they're healthy and happy. But when the water is a little hot, they do not like that. So what happens to them is that they release their plants and they become white. Oh. So we're gonna find that out with this experiment.
So that's a healthy coral that you have in there.
I have a healthy coral right here. Can you see how beautiful their color is? Its color is?
Can you see it?
What color does it have?
Orange.
Orange, beautiful orange or red. And this is a staghorn coral. This is a little fragment. So now what I need you to do is put it inside of the water. What happened to it? It turned white. This is what happens to corals in the ocean. When their water gets too hot, they don't really like it. They don't really like it, and they lose their colors. They become bleached. Can you say coral bleaching, please?
Coral bleaching.
Coral bleaching. This is what a healthy coral looks like. You see all beautiful colors, and then you can see it when it's bleached. That means that the water got too hot and the corals got stressed. That means they got upset and they lost their colors because they lost their friends, their algae. They have a symbiotic relationship with algae. Can you say algae?
Algae. Which one looks better, the healthy coral or the bleached coral?
Healthy.
Healthy. And why did it get bleached? What happened? What happened?
Warm water.
That's right. Warm water bleached it. Good.
Exactly.
Looking. Good observation.
It's been amazing learning about coral and coral reefs. They are a very important part of our world's ecosystem. We now know that we can all do our part to keep our oceans healthy.